Welcome to Reality Creative Video. I'm Hermes, and today we're going to do a start to finish on iron, chromium, and nickel. There is the actual finished product that you see there, this nice dark amber color. Basically, we're cooking iron with a couple of other extra ingredients in it. Now, I'm using stainless number 304 stainless steel. There is various kinds of stainless steel that have different ingredients in them, depending. So I chose this one because I want the nickel and I want the chromium, and of course the iron. Now those are three very good nutrients for the body. Iron, lots of people have iron deficiencies. Colloidal iron is an excellent source of boosting your iron deficiency. It's already bioavailable because it's a colloidal nanoparticle, so your bloodstream can just absorb it. You don't have to take an iron pill that has to be broken down. So, and chromium is very good for your metabolism, especially if you guys are on a diet or you're exercising, or, you know, trying to stay fit. Chromium is needed to maintain a high metabolism. And nickel is an ingredient that is key to the blood, to keep the blood working. So those three ingredients are really good. They come in different proportions. Let's get the proportions right. It's 74% iron, 18% chromium, 8% nickel. And all those things are good for you. So that gives us, that's an amalgam. And that's going to give us the picture that you see over there, which I'll give you a blow up here of what that the finished product actually looks like. So most of it is gone is iron, as you can see. And this is the dark, rich amber color. Now this, you guys have been following me for a long time. You're gonna like this one because it cooks fast. You wanna know how fast it cooks? 20 minutes. This dark amber color was reached in 20 minutes. So, but it's one of the more complicated things to cook. I use the gold formula. That's the same formula that to cook this, I use the gold formula, which is the same formula that I use to cook gold. So we're going to briefly go through that. So the first thing you're going to do is I heated the water to 60 degrees C. You don't have to heat the water to 60 degrees C if you don't want to. I did it because I wanted it to go faster. Now, the first batch of colloidal stainless steel here that I cooked took 2 hours, and I didn't want it to take 2 hours, and I didn't use any heat, so I figured, well, I'm going to boost it with a little bit of heat, so I raised it up to 60 degrees C, and it cooked in 20 minutes. So the good part about this whole thing is you don't need to weigh the rods, though you can if you want to, because you're just going to go by the color. This is a dark amber color. And when you reach this color, you've hit 50 parts per million of the colloidal stainless steel. Now, this is an earlier batch that I made, and you can see the color is lighter. This one's a 36 parts per million stainless steel batch. You can cook it to whatever parts per million you want. Probably can even go darker than that if you wanted it darker, but that is about as dark as I'd like to go. I mean, 50 parts per million for a colloidal is pretty darn potent. All right, so now let's get to the making of it, okay? Like I said, we're going to heat, you're going to do 500 milliliters of water. You're going to heat it to 50 degrees C or 60 degrees C. And you're going to have to do stock solutions. You're going to need, now, if you've watched my gold video, you'll know you're going to need to make a stock solution of sodium citrate. That guy don't belong there. Sodium citrate and NaCl. Now, for NaCl, I use sea salt. Sodium citrate, you pick it up online. Naturally, I'll have the links to all of this stuff in the description. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to take 7.35 grams in 500 milliliters of distilled water of sodium citrate and mix it in here. And just, you know, you just put it in there. You can use a little kitchen scale. I have my three-digit scale. But Thankfully, these things do not need a three-digit expensive scale. You could just put your powder on here, measure it up, and then dump it in. The NaCl is going to be 1.5 grams in 500 milliliters of distilled water. You're going to have to make corn syrup too, and that is, let's see, the corn syrup. Okay, you're going to take 30 milliliters of straight corn syrup, put it in a little glass, and you're going to mix it with 20 milliliters of distilled water, and you're going to mix those two up, which are going to give you a 50 milliliter solution that you're going to put in an eyedropper. And the reason we thin it down is so that you can put it in an eyedropper and use it. You're going to need a stirrer or some way to agitate the fluid using an air pump or something like that. With all the colloidals, you really need some kind of agitation or stirrer involved, or you're just going to get unpredictable results. So you put your 8 drops of corn syrup in. Then you're going to dump 10 milliliters of the sodium citrate. And then you're going to dump the 40 milliliters of NaCl in there. You're going to turn the power supply on. I'm using 37.5 volts. And it's going to draw about 180 milliamps. So your little 5-volt power supply is not going to work for this, okay? Because it's going to take 180 milliamps, and 5 volts is way too low. So you need at least 30, you need at least a 30 volt supply. 25, you might get away with a 25 volt supply. You don't want to go for, you know, you can get one of those 36 volt power bricks, that should work. There's an anode and a cathode. The anode is the negative of the power supply. And I use a carbon rod for all my anodes except for all of my colloidals except for gold. And the cathode is going to be the metal that you want to cook, which is going to be stainless steel, in this case 304 stainless steel. And you're going to then turn on the power supply. Stuff will start to change color fairly rapidly, and like I said, just wait. All right, you have any questions, leave me some comments below and I will answer them. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creative Video, and I will talk to you again soon.